Hi, I'm Tasos with RF Elements. Thank you for joining our webinar today. Today we'll be discussing our symmetrical horn antennas with TwistPort technology and all the unique benefits from these types of antennas. First of all, I'd like to introduce RF Elements. Our company was established in 2010 in Slovakia. We currently have 73 people working at RF Elements, mainly in developing new products. We have two offices in Slovakia, one in Bratislava and one in Humene. We also have an office in Austin, Texas to support the Americas. Our main focus is innovation and innovative products. Our products are different. They work better and look better than their competitors. We manufacture products for building wireless networks. Our customers are ISPs, Internet Service Providers. In 2014, we introduced a brand new concept based on our quick-locking waveguide connector TwistPort. We have defined a new reference design for radios and antennas without RF connectors or RF cables. We named radios with our TwistPort connector Simper, and we introduced a completely new series of antennas and TwistPort adapters for the integration of other vendors' radios. Today I'm going to speak about symmetrical horn antennas with TwistPort connectors, which are part of our TwistPort ecosystem. The first thing that you will notice on this antenna is its unusual shape. Symmetrical horn antennas are a scalar horn type of antenna. The next thing that you will notice on this antenna is its unique connector. It is called a TwistPort connector, our proprietary patent-pending waveguide connector. It brings many benefits from which we will talk about the two main ones, no loss and simplicity. TwistPort allows the connection of radios to the antenna virtually without loss. We use the term virtually because there is a very small loss, but if we compare it to traditional coaxial connectors, the loss is almost unmeasurable. TwistPort also offers a very simple installation of the radio to TwistPort adapters. You just twist and lock the radio. It is very easy and can be done with one hand. As I already mentioned, symmetrical horn antennas are a scalar horn type of antenna. The shape of the beam is different than traditional sector antennas. The beam of a traditional sector antenna is usually very wide in azimuth, but too narrow in elevation. On the other hand, the beam of a symmetrical horn antenna is symmetrical with precise width. It is similar to a beam of light that is created in a flashlight when you turn it on. The beam of these antennas are very unique. The main beam is circular. Radiation angles are the same in azimuth as well as elevation. This feature brings many benefits in real-life deployments. The first benefit that a symmetrical horn antenna brings is the coverage area without a null zone. Thanks to the fact that the radiation angle and elevation is wide, by using these antennas you can provide connectivity to customers that are close into the tower. This is not possible with traditional sector antennas that have very narrow radiation angles in the elevation plane. Symmetrical horn antennas have a frequency constant beam. When changing frequencies, the beam does not significantly change its shape and it stays constant as you can see in this animation. With traditional sector antennas, the beam is strongly frequency dependent, so when you change channels, you can lose connectivity with previously connected clients. You don't have to worry about that with symmetrical horn antennas. This simulation shows how the beam of a traditional sector antenna changes with frequency. It is becoming narrower in azimuth and wider in elevation plane. With symmetrical horn antennas, the delta is really small. The shape of the beam is still the same. Not only does the shape of the beam not change with frequency, but also gain of symmetrical horn antennas is frequency stable and does not change as much as with traditional sectors. The gain shown on these graphs is of our 30-degree symmetrical horn antenna in horizontal and vertical polarizations. As you can see, the antenna has a gain of around 18 dBi across the whole frequency range, and moreover, the gain is completely the same for both polarizations. This is very important for performance of MIMO links. And now the best thing. Symmetrical horn antennas do not have any side lobes. Really, no side lobes at all. On the left side, there is a very popular antenna from a competitor, which operates in the 5 GHz band, has 19 dBi of gain, and is spec'd at 120-degree radiation angle. The simulation clearly shows side lobes on the side and back of the antenna. These side lobes are a huge source of interference for all other antennas. In the second simulation on the right, you can see that symmetrical horn antennas radiate in the main beam and do not have any side lobes. Other clients and antennas on the side will not interfere with symmetrical horns. It's important to realize the fact that symmetrical horn antennas do not have side lobes benefits you in two ways. It means that the antenna does not create interference, but also it does not receive any interference outside of the main lobe. On the other hand, the antenna on the left just creates a lot of interference and also receives lots of noise from the back and sides thanks to its massive side lobes. Side lobes are not just a problem of cheap antennas. As an example of expensive antennas, the simulation on the left shows a more recent AC antenna from a competitor with a 45-degree radiation angle. The MSRP price of this antenna is about $200. As you can see, there are less side lobes than with the previous antenna, but they still exist. What's more important to note is the main lobe in this polarization is aiming slightly to the left, which affects the overall performance of the sector in real-world deployments. On the right side, you can see how well our symmetrical horn antennas work. It does not have any side lobes, and the main lobe is aiming directly forward in both polarizations. Currently, we offer 7 models of symmetrical horn antennas with radiation angles from 30 to 90 with 10-degree steps. As you can see, the radiation angle is very precise. Precise radiation angles without side lobes allow you to scale your network as you need it. You don't have to choose from just a few options such as 120 degree, 90 degree, or even 45 degrees to design your network accordingly. With symmetrical horn antennas, you can finally plan your network as it should be done. This means using the right antennas with reasonable gain to cover only the area where you really have customers and do not pollute precious spectrum by propagating signal elsewhere and thus creating noise. It is important to realize that by choosing the correct antenna with suitable radiation patterns and proper gain, you will reduce the noise level in your environment and increase the throughput of your network. From multiple real-world deployments, we know the distances that our customers were able to achieve. For example, a customer in Mexico was able to achieve a 25-kilometer link with a 30-degree symmetrical horn antenna and a 31 dBi rocket dish as a client. In Guatemala, another customer achieved a 24-kilometer link with a 60-degree symmetrical horn antenna and a 30 dBi rocket dish as a client, all in point-to-multipoint. This is just an interesting fact because using sectors for long distances is something that you should definitely try to avoid, but is possible if needed. Another benefit of symmetrical horn antennas is their compact size. The size is 1/4 that of a traditional sector antenna. This allows you to deploy symmetrical horn antennas where you are limited on space or you need to reduce the wind loading on your tower. Symmetrical horn antennas are made from high quality and durable materials. All the metal parts are made out of aluminum, plastic parts are made of UV-resistant plastics, and hardware is from stainless steel. There are no surface-treated materials that can corrode, so symmetrical horn antennas can be used in very demanding weather conditions and harsh environments. Our customers are using these antennas in different conditions, from Alaska to subtropic areas to deserts without a problem. Let's summarize when you should use a symmetrical horn antenna. First reason is a problem with interference. Symmetrical horn antennas do not have any side lobes, so they do not receive signal outside the main lobe, which means they do not receive noise. Also, symmetrical horns are perfect if you need to use a narrow sector, either due to geographical topology or location of your clients when they are not distributed over a wide area. Narrow sectors are necessary when you have a huge number of customers concentrated in an area. Splitting such an overcrowded sector into a few narrow sectors will allow you to cover the same amount of customers but with more APs, so you will be able to achieve higher throughputs. Another scenario where you could use symmetrical horns are in hills, mountains, and valleys. In this case, you require good vertical performance. Symmetrical horns have the same horizontal and vertical performance, so you can cover even clients that are on the same elevation level. These antennas solve the null issue and they can cover areas that are close to your tower. No electrical or mechanical down tilt is needed, and thanks to their compact size, you can use them when space on your tower is limited or you can't put more equipment on the tower due to wind load issues. Here is just a brief overview of some symmetrical horn technical parameters. The rest of the parameters you can find in data sheets that can be downloaded from our webpage, www.rfelements.com. We are glad to see so many positive feedbacks from our customers. AU Wireless, a provider from the US, replaced antennas from a competitor with our symmetrical horn TwistPort antennas. As you can see, they perform very well. No problems with side lobes, improved SNR, and perfect coverage in an elevation complex install. Excellent feedback from a customer in Nigeria. Nuruddin was previously not able to provide even 2 megs per client, even when the signal level was good. After he replaced a competitor's antenna with our 40-degree symmetrical horn antenna, the problems were gone and he was able to operate and maintain an 80 MHz channel. Starnet is a wireless service provider in Albania. After they replaced their previous antennas with symmetrical horn TwistPort antennas, they achieved significant improvements in signal level as well as throughput. So they decided to use these antennas also on their future installations. You can find a case study from StarNet on our website in the testimonial section. We have many positive feedbacks from our customers. You can find them on our YouTube channel as well. We would appreciate it if you can leave your feedback on our community portal, www.rfelab.com. Share your feedback with other ISPs, ask us questions, and share your ideas with us. If you'd like to learn more about our products, you can go to our website, www.rfelements.com. Also, we are present on many different social networks such as Facebook, Google+, LinkedIn, and Twitter, where you can follow us. On our YouTube channel, you can find many interesting videos, for example, interviews with customers that are using our symmetrical horn TwistPort antennas and speaking about their experiences with these antennas, what they achieved, and how they like it. Thanks again for taking the time out of your day to watch our webinar. I hope you learned a lot of new information about our products and how they can benefit you. Have a good day and stay tuned for our next webinar. Bye.